Hey guys, today we are going to be making a recipe that I think you guys are absolutely going to love. I was blown away when I actually tried these, and they legitimately taste like potato French fries. Like, not even a joke, not even pretend cauliflower fries, not even pretend zucchini fries, legitimate potato French fries. The best part about this recipe is that it's only two ingredients. That's right, two ingredients. It couldn't be any more simple than that. So there's two different ways that you can make these fries. They're so easy. I'm telling you guys that it only took me 30 minutes to put these together, throw these together, and I'm not even joking. And the cool thing is you actually can make a larger batch of these, keep them in your freezer, and then pop them in the toaster oven or in the oven to heat them up later, and they're gonna taste just as good as if you made them fresh. You're gonna make these with either almond flour or coconut flour, your choice. So that's what makes these really kind of cool, because you can make them both ways and they're going to taste equally as amazing both ways you make these. So I polled my community here on YouTube, and almost 700 of you guys, 656 of you guys said if you could make one food magically keto, you would choose French fries. And so I'm so excited to share this with you guys today. The one benefit of the coconut flour, in my opinion, is that you're not gonna be consuming as many nuts. And so if you're following a ketogenic, low carb, high fat lifestyle and you're trying to cut back on the nuts, maybe going for a coconut flour flour is ideal for you. This is my preferred way of making it. There is different measurements for each. So if you're doing the coconut flour version, you're going to be using half the amount as if you are using the almond flour version, okay? So I'm gonna break it down for you really easily so you can see how to measure this out. So easy, guys. You're gonna love me forever for bringing you this one. The one food that could destroy my entire keto journey is potatoes. And so we're going to take that temptation away if that is the way you feel as well. And so we're going to make this really super simple to add some French fries back into our lifestyle. The coconut flour, the other advantage is it's not gonna have like jaggedy edges, but if you prefer your fries to be more rough around the edges and not so much like stick fries, then maybe you prefer almond flour because it's gonna be a little bit more jaggedy edged than the coconut flour. Also, I feel like it's just easier to mold and to mesh together than the almond flour. So our second ingredient is xanthan gum. This I just picked up on Amazon. All of the links to these I'll put in the description so you can grab these on Amazon. This is what's so crazy about this recipe. You would never guess, never in a million years would you guess that you can mix only, you're gonna pick one of these flours, coconut flour and xanthan gum and water, and you're gonna make the absolute best French fries you've ever tasted in your life. So I'm not even joking about that. Please make these, put it in the comments how you enjoyed them, how you love them, and I would love to hear that. And also, if you have any friends that are doing the ketogenic lifestyle, share this video with them, because this one recipe could literally save them from falling off track with the ketogenic lifestyle. You're gonna see how super easy it is, and then we're going to also try these at the end of this video. We're gonna try them, see how they taste, and we're also going to try the air fryer version, because I know a lot of you guys cook with air fryers. You can also bake these, however, I have not tried them baked yet, but I do use my air fryer all the time, so I wanted to test it out that way to see how it tastes, if it works out or not, because there's going to be a lot of oil that you use within this recipe. You need olive oil to fry these. So that's the method that really I know for sure 110% is gonna make these taste like French fries. So let's make these also the secondary way and try them out in the air fryer and see how they taste at the end.
So we're gonna start with the flour, and we're going to be using two different measurements depending on the type of flour you decided on. So if you're doing coconut flour or almond flour, it's just different, so just be aware of that. And then we're gonna add the xanthan, I think I'm pronouncing that right, I have no idea, gum, however it's pronounced, I'm not sure, but you add that with the specific measurements, and then this is really important, really key. You want to be using hot water. So I just took hot water out of the tap, and then I put it in the microwave for a couple minutes just to get it like really, really steamy hot. And then you measure out based on the type of flour that you chose for your fries. You measure that out, and then we're going to just combine this and mix it up so that it's really well combined. Okay, so that's really super important as we're forming these fries, that you get it combined really well. And then we're going to roll it up into a ball. And like I mentioned before, it's definitely going to be rougher around the edges if it's almond flour, but the coconut flour that I'm showing you here today is pretty smooth and nice. So we're going to let that chill and cool down. Let that sit for just a little bit, and then we're gonna roll it out. As you can see, my kids ran away with my rolling pin, and so I'm using the next best thing, which is my baby's bottle. It's okay, whatever we have on hand, right? So that's that. So you're just gonna roll it out to make it nice and flat, and then you're going to shape this into a rectangle. And any areas that you need to fill in, you can definitely do that with the pieces that you cut off the edge to make sure it's a nice rectangle that you can slice into even French fries. So that's what I'm doing here. So first I'm cutting off the edges, and then I'm going through and I'm going to slice up every single piece. Now it's really important that you make these thin because they are going to puff up a little bit when you cook them. So try to make them nice and small. The coconut flour I did find to be much more easier to stick together. So like the almond flour kind of breaks apart a little bit easier. This method does stick together better. So get those all sliced up. And now we're gonna take our pan and we're gonna put it over medium to low heat. So right in between medium and low. And the reason we're doing that is because we don't want to burn these fries, but we want the oil to get nice and medium hot. Okay, so you want them to cook through and get golden brown. You don't want them to be burnt, right, around the edges. So that's really important. You definitely want it to just be bubbling, just like you see here. You're gonna start seeing it bubble up, and you're going to want to toss them a little bit in the oil, get them really well coated, and follow this in a very nice, even cooking through so that we're able to cook it. So I don't know how long it took me to actually do this. I was just kind of sitting here and turning them as time went on, and just making sure I wasn't burning them. And then they're gonna puff up. So what I did was I took them out of the oven when they were, or of the pan when they were about halfway cooked, and then I sliced them even smaller. So I took the puffed up fries, and it's okay if you like them a little bit thicker, you can keep them that way, but I really wanted the shoestring fries, so I took them out and I just sliced each of them in half to make them just a little bit smaller. So you can do that, up to you, totally preference, depends on what you want to do. And so then I threw them back in the oil and I tossed them a little bit longer until they got to be a really nice golden crispy brown. And then I started pulling them off and actually gave my kids a try. All right, you guys wanna try them?
Yeah.
Does it taste like French fries? Like real ones? So as you can see, they absolutely love them. And so once these were really just perfect to come off the oil, I took them off, put them on a paper towel, and let these cool down a little bit. Now, let me show you the second method, which is the air fryer method. For this, I coated the strips right after we chopped them up and sliced them up before putting them in the oil. With this method, instead of that, we're going to be coating the strips with oil and then sticking them in our air fryer. So I have one of these Foodie Ninja air fryers. And so what I did was I just put them evenly at the bottom of the pan, the air fryer. I don't even know what this would even be called, but whatever this pan thing is inside my air fryer. And I set it to 20 minutes, but these actually only took 15 minutes before they were done. I probably could have left them in a little bit longer. They definitely could have probably stayed in there the full 20 minutes. But for this, I did put them in 15 minutes. And throughout the cooking, I just made sure to come in and add a little bit more oil to them, to toss them up and make sure that they're broken up because they will stick together a little bit. All right guys, so here we go with the final result. I have the fries two different ways. We have the fried in olive oil method that I showed you, and then we have the air fryer fries. Now let's do a little taste test and see how they are. So here's
the fries fried in the olive oil. So amazing. Like, if you are going to a restaurant, you want some fries, you order fries, and these were served to you, you would not know the difference. I swear to you, you would not know the difference. They are literally that good. So let's try our air fryer fries, which you can see there is a little bit of texture to them. And now these are, both of these are the coconut flour prepared the exact same way. The only difference is the method that I baked them or cooked them. So let's try the air fryer fries to see how these are so you guys can see. You know what they taste like? The air fryer method reminds me more so of like if you bought a big bag of frozen French fries and you baked some frozen French fries. And I think the reason for that is because the pan-fried fries with more oil is gonna absorb more of the oil, so it's going to take on a lot of that flavor, and it's going to be a little bit, these are crispy. Like you can see, these are definitely very crispy, very, very good. Both ways are really good. So really, I think it depends on if you're really looking for that higher fat for keto, then I would go with the oil in the pan. If you're someone who's like, you know what, I just want to cut back a little bit on the fat, then probably doing it in the air fryer would be just fine. You can do it with like a side of ranch, different ways that you can do this. Also, you could like drizzle some truffle oil on there. Oh my gosh, so amazing. The other thing that I was thinking that is absolutely incredible is that this is shelf stable. So it's like, it's not going to take up any room in your freezer. It's not going to take up any room in your refrigerator. It's not going to go bad. You stick it in your, you know, you have like coconut flour or almond flour. It's in your pantry. So you can whip this together as a side dish literally anytime without having food on hand. So that happens a lot with me. Like I will have maybe some chicken in the refrigerator and I'm like, what can I make? This is a great side dish without having to be like, okay, well, I don't have any broccoli. I don't have this. I don't have that. I don't have zucchini, but I do have a big bag of coconut flour and some xanthium gum. So I'm gonna whip up some French fries, keto French fries, and have that tonight. And the other thing is my kids tried these. They absolutely love them. My daughter, before I put her to bed last night, she wanted more. She was like asking for more. She's like, can I have more French fries, more French fries? They could not even tell the difference, which is crazy to me because, well, it's actually not crazy because I can't tell the difference either. They taste like potato French fries. So it's really an amazing swap and different type of choice for you to make. All right guys, well thanks for watching this one. Be sure you hit that subscribe button. If you are new here and new to the low carb, high fat, ketogenic lifestyle, I have the video that you wanna check out next coming up right here. And if you are new to my journey and haven't checked out my transformation, you definitely wanna watch that video because it's sure to inspire you today. And if you have some friends who are following keto that could really use this recipe in their lifestyle, share it with them. And I will love you forever. And that's just the way it is. So listen, check out the description because I have the recipe in the description for you guys.